is when I was young at this program, Professor Pitt told me that the AT&T, the big telecom company, they have tons of thousands of physical contracts stored in their inventory, and no one has ever examined into them to see if they have any problems or any risk contained in those contracts, because the auditors just don't have that much time and energy to do that. So it's kind of a legacy problem that left behind in some area and waiting to be solved. So I just take a look at that. And so first of all, I will say, is contract important in the audit process? So I go over the audit standards in US and I find that contracts are very important documents during planning and risk assessment, compliance, substantive testing, and also the review stage.
What is contract?
Contracts. So basically, if, let's say,
AT&T and a vendor has a
contract.
It's a document.
They are all documents.
So, well, usually auditors just focus on those significant contracts. For example, if you talk about CEO compensation contracts, the auditors just hire a lawyer and read through those contracts to make sure there's no significant risk associated with these contracts. But when you think of those insignificant contracts, like I said, if you have lease agreements, you're a leasing company, and you lease thousands of equipment out to your customers, and there will be tons of contracts. If you look at one single contract, you won't identify any significant result as risk, but if you combine everything together, there may be a significant risk or error inside, because you can only examine things in aggregated amount. So to address those questions, I just took a look into the text mining in literature, and also here is a list of the recent text mining techniques used by accounting researchers. So there's been a trend for more and more use, but most of them look at the financial statements, and I just want to see if they can be applied to those documents as well. So based on that, I propose this contract analytics framework. Basically, it contains six steps. So I begin with this document management. So in this step, I try to aggregate all the documents together. So most of the contracts, if you think of that, they have signature on there. So they are scanned with a machine and then stored as PDF. Mm-hmm. So here I use a Google Tensor OCR to just convert all this image into text, and they have those the latest technique. They have this train database that I can use. I apply all this process through Python coding. So they have this train data set, so for a better conversion. And then I use I give a document classification, meaning I want to, if you think of all this insignificant contracts, there's a high probability that they are created with templates. So I want to see which contracts belong to the same group and which contracts belong to another group. And if one of your clients saying, I'm giving you this bunch of sales contracts for this vehicle, and you see one contract is significantly different from others, you know there's a problem going on. And also, there will be an abstract summarization function which creates a little abstract for the contract. Usually, it's not that useful, but I just create there so that auditors can go back to see the abstract rather than to see the content of the contract. The next one is the fundamental for my analysis. So in this content identification, I want to give text to each terms or sentence. And this step, with enough sample, I can do that with a machine learning way. And actually, there are already commercial software, commercial tools in the market that can already do this. But what I find is that the usage of that kind of tools are usually by lawyers. They use that to go through contracts to find the date and the amount and also some terms. Rather, auditors are not, to my knowledge, auditors are not using that, but they are starting to look at this type of software soon. But I hear a few from the meetings I attend with from auditors of the Big Four firms. So what I propose next is I can use all the information tag in the content identification for the following test. For example, cutoff testing. I want to see whether the contract should be included in this testing period, whether it should be included for the next period. And then also some, because audit is a more like a period of time rather than a point of time, so I also want to see if there's some change to the contracts happen, I should be able to detect that during the audit process.
What is the contract month year? What is the contract month year?
Contract month year?
Yeah, contract, five-year contract. So
5-year contract.
How do you reach the cutoff?
So during that part, you have this ability to say, whether you want to determine that it's within this year, or whether it's more like not a predefined process, it's more like customized. You can define that. Yeah. So the record confirmation is where I extract the records from the contract, for example, the sales amount, and I set confirmation to the third party, to the buyer, and say, I want to confirm with you about this amount. And I usually, in academic, if we send out a questionnaire, we get a very low response. So to mediate that, I propose use this robotic process automation, RPA, to send to every client. So even with a very low response rate, we can still get some part of a response of the confirmation. And then the database validation is some of the company will have their internal database, have a record of all these transactions. But what we are doing here is we extract records from contracts, then compare these contracts, these records to what they have in their database. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of a validation process. Mm-hmm. And last one is term verification. After extracting the numbers, the terms, we want to see whether the template itself has been like tempered or modified. So currently I'm using this TF-IDF and cosine similarity to compare the similarity score between two big pages. Well, usually, ideally, you can just run a line-by-line comparison, but in the OCR process, a lot of errors occur there, and what we find this method is more like robust to noise. So with all this result from here, we can apply them to the to help auditors in error and fraud evaluation, compliance risk assessment, mitigation assessment, or substantive test. So mostly I would say the most contribution would be in substantive test. And here is, I just go through the audit standards and see how my framework can be applied to some audit work there. And I thought the most contribution is in the substantive test. So I apply this framework using some sample data from one of the Big Four audit firms. They have a reinsurance client in the reinsurance industry, and I only get 10 because it's really hard to ask contracts from the company. And they need to cross out all the sensitive information with their legal department. Although we only have 10, but each contract has around 30,000 words, which is long contracts. And they are created like with template and also variable, meaning they are created from template, fitting all the record in there. So to showcase how the framework work, I use number one as the template. Usually in the case, auditors just receive the template, but here we don't have that, so we treat number one as a template and also manually embed the two arrows in number two. So we take one paragraph on one page, put that on another page, just to see if we can identify that. And also add another reinsurance agreement created from a different template but from the same client. And we first use OCR to convert the image to text, and then we use cosine similarity, the score, to see how each sample is similar to number one, the template. So number one itself has 100%, all other text is about more than 99%, only number 11, where we created with different template, has a very low percentage, similar percentage. So saying number 11 should not belong to this group of contracts. And then the second step is the content identification. So because we only have 10 here, so we modified the approach a little bit to use regular expression. And so the first step is to tell the auditors to look at, read our contracts to see what variable they are interested at. So here we name a few of them, policy number, premium amount, period of insurance, etc. And then after identifying that, we write regular expression to match the pattern of the variable. And with that done, we just run the regular expression, we can extract the record. So here is the output of the content identification. So we extract all the, I modified the format to be more friendly to PowerPoint. But basically, it's a big table contains all the variables here. And we just look at several missing values here. We look at some gross premium and also some missing policy number here, or they all include some, indicate some problem. And this, all these 10 reinsurance contracts contain the same thing in the limit of liability category. But this process are all customizable, meaning if you want more variable, we can name different variable and then extract them all. Then the last one, what we did is more like term verification. We want to see whether the template itself has been modified. So we compare page by page. So contract, the first page of contract number two to first page of contract number one, second page of contract number two to second page of contract number one. So we do this 10 times, 9 times to apply to all those sample contracts. So what you see here is the orange dot is sample number two. You see there's two outliers here showing these two pages are significantly different from the page in contract number one. A regular one would be act like sample number three, the gray diamond, almost always above 99%. So these two pages are actually where we subtract one paragraph and put to another. So we also find some interesting irregular patterns. Here you see some pages that are different from the template, but they're acting, several contracts are acting like the same way. So when I go back to the original document, this is not the original document, but more than a demonstration purpose. So it's not aligned properly, it's like too that way. And also, so when OCR, it should recognize this first and this column after. But it will recognize some part of this, some part of this, and like mess with the page numbers. So that's why you see several contracts that are performing the same way. So yeah, basically that's the end of the contract analysis. Thank you.